before we get to the video, with our favorite lispy sprite
Anchor Baby
from Vox. It's ridiculous. It's bonkers. You're being given a free pass as a crappy writer because you're gay.
That center line on his little queer graph there. What is
well,
that
now
line?
The graph is queer?
This is what Mr. Gay Vox wants to do.
Mr. Lispy Queer from Vox.
What were you holding, Gay Latino from Vox?
So tell me what the last 24 hours have been like for you.
Just a carnival of horrors. Like maybe the worst day of my life. In my gut, there was like this like bullied gay teenager that thought, I have all the evidence, I've done my work, I exposed myself to the public, I've used YouTube policies and by the letter of those policies, and this has to work. Like, how could any decent human who says they care about queer people not react to this? And it wasn't enough.
Well, let me ask you about the policies that they said, the rationale for not kicking Crowder off. And they told us this. They said, in videos flagged to YouTube, Crowder has not instructed his viewers to harass Maz on YouTube or any other platform. And the main point of these videos was not to harass or threaten, but rather to respond to the opinion. And they said that none of your personal information was ever revealed in content uploaded by Crowder. What do you say to that?
That's an insane policy, because it essentially means that the only way you can get kicked off YouTube is if you give my address and instruct millions of people to harass me. Abuse, there's a lot of abuse that happens before someone gives your address. And it doesn't matter if he ever encouraged his followers to harass me. He was doing it. That was the harm. A person with 4 million subscribers was calling me a lispy queer unsolicited in front of a massive audience. And I had to deal with the abuse that resulted as of that. YouTube is essentially saying that the price for participating in political discussions on YouTube is that you have to be willing to accept people criticizing you for being gay and for being Hispanic. That's an insane policy. YouTube knows it's insane. They know that this isn't something they're planning to enforce. They're making excuses to avoid doing the difficult thing, which is dealing with a monster that they spent years creating.
So I want to ask you about the concern that some people have about enabling these powerful large tech companies to define what is acceptable speech on their platforms. Are you concerned about enabling tech companies to make those decisions?
Totally. It's a legitimate concern. And as a queer person, I recognize that like big corporations have not been particularly friendly to us in the past and that this could really go sideways. There are a lot of speech questions that actually are messy calls, which is why I understand in general why platforms say it's tough to enforce these policies because there are a lot of gray areas. That is not what is happening here. YouTube is looking at clear examples of abuse and saying it's not bad enough. And even though we might have the ability to post on YouTube, the ability to speak on these platforms, if there aren't policies to protect us from abuse, we don't have meaningful access to speech. It limits our ability to meaningfully participate on speech platforms, and that speech should be valued more than the speech of someone who's using the platform to call someone unsolicited a lispy queer for 2 years. That is not valuable speech. That's not worthy of protection.